Hello and welcome to Giddy Knits episode number 4. I'm Helen and you can find me on Ravelry and Instagram as Giddy Helen. And this is my knitting podcast where I talk to you about some finished objects that I finished knitting this week, some knitting that I've currently got on the go, some lovely yarny things that have come to live with me, and a little bit about my everyday family life and what I've been up to in the last couple of weeks. I'm coming to you on Wednesday the 15th of March 2017, and I'm coming from Surrey in the United Kingdom, where I live with my husband Tom and my two boys, Arthur, who is 3 years old, and Jasper, who is 4.5 months old. I just want to say welcome to returning viewers, so anyone that's watched me before, thank you for coming back. I hope you've been enjoying it. And also welcome to any new viewers who've come to join me for the first time. Thank you so much for checking me out, and I really hope you enjoy the episode. So those of you that have watched me before will notice that I am recording in the daylight and not in the evening for a change. I'm trying it out. I'm hoping that the light will be a little bit better. I am getting a bit of glare off my glasses from the window, so I'm sorry about that if I keep looking up, and I'll try and avoid it as much as I can. Jasper is having a nap at the moment. Tom's actually working from home today. He's just got back from a work trip to Poland, so he is not going into work today. So he's actually in the bedroom with Jasper. Jasper's asleep. But we may have a bit of a parenting interruption if Jasper wakes up and I need to go and deal with him. But hopefully he'll stay asleep and he'll have a nice nap and we'll be able to get through all the lovely knitting. Okay, so let's delve right in then. This week I want to talk to you about some finished objects that I've got to show you, also some works in progress. I've got one new cast on to show you. I have got some more yarny goodness to show you as well. And also then I'll just finish off with my behind the scenes section at the end where I show you what we've been up to in the last couple of weeks. So let's start with some finished objects. These are both things that you've seen before, but I finally finished them. So to start, first of all, I have finished, see if I can get these sensibly, my Neville socks. These are what I am calling my Wizard in Wonderland socks. And last time I showed you them, I had got one complete and I was very close to finishing the other. I knit my socks cuff down and I was pretty much here. So I literally had a few rows and then the toe to add in. So it's not surprising that these are finished this week. And I've shown them before, so I won't go into too much detail, but the pattern is the Neville sock by Erica Lueder, which is a free pattern on Ravelry. And it is based on Neville Longbottom from Harry Potter. It's inspired by him. And the yarn is Peggy May Yarns. And this was a one-of-a-kind, an exclusive, that's the word I want, an exclusive colourway. She did an Alice in Wonderland yarn box last year. And this was the yarn that came with it. And let's see if this light will show the colours right. Here we go. And it is just these gorgeous pink and light blue, and then reds and browns and sort of creamy colours in there as well. And it is very nice. I loved how these knitted up in kind of almost like a stripey spiral. And I did contrasting heels and toes. So this is Cascade Heritage in there, just the grey colourway. I don't think it's got a colourway name really. And I'm really happy with them. These are the first ones where I knitted the foot a little bit longer, so they actually fit me really, really nicely. I haven't blocked them or washed them yet. And as you may have noticed, for those of you that watched before, I've given up on my sock blocker. I will buy some sock blockers at some point, but Arthur got hold of the one I made, which actually is over here. He got hold of it and it's a bit, it got played with a little bit. So it's not really going to hold its shape very well. But oh well, it's fine. We can show you. And I think you can see these well enough without them being on a sock blocker anyway. But yeah, I'm really, really happy with these. The yarn, as I said, was Peggy May Yarns. In the Alice in Wonderland was the name of the colourway, as it was Alice in Wonderland inspired. Sorry, I'm just spotting one of my hairs there. And I'm entering these into a few knit-alongs. In fact, I think I might be quadruple dipping these. But these are going into the Box of Socks KAL, hosted by the Yarngasm Podcast. They're also going into the Free All the House Elves KAL, hosted by Yarn Hoarder Podcast. And they're also, I keep saying also because there's four of them, so they're also going into the year-long Harry Potter knit-along, hosted by Inside Number 23. And finally, I've entered them into the Geeky Sock-along, hosted by the Happy Knitting Podcast as well. So obviously these are Harry Potter inspired because of the fact that the pattern is the Neville sock. You can see right there. And they're also geeky because, well, they kind of cross two fandoms really, because you've got the Harry Potter aspect, but also the Alice in Wonderland aspect is also appropriate for that. I really enjoyed this pattern. I think I mentioned last time that some people said that, I've heard that people have said that they found the pattern tedious after a while, but actually I really enjoyed it. It was really simple, it was really easy to follow. I didn't need to keep looking at the pattern once I'd got the hang of it. And I'm really happy with how it looks, and I really enjoyed knitting them. I knit them pretty much to the pattern. The only thing that I did differently was that I did 15 rows for my cuff instead of 20, because I like a shorter cuff. I get bored knitting a cuff. I have to finish it a bit sooner. But I did do the heel in the pattern. It's a free pattern, so I can talk about it in detail. Just work out which one. Yeah, I did do the heel in the pattern. It's a slip stitch heel, but it's just a straight slip stitch heel, but modified with the garter edge. I like the garter edge in a heel, flat heel. And I think is it called a Dutch heel turn? The heel turn that's slightly squarer than a normal one. But yeah, so I'm really happy with these, and I am looking forward to wearing them. Now my second finished object is also a pair of socks. I finished my purple stripy socks. So last time I showed them, I had finished one sock and I had literally finished the cuff of the second sock. I was here where the little marker is there. So I have finished the second sock completely. And I'm really, really happy with these. This yarn is Owl About Yarn in her Lilac Mist colourway. And it's just this lovely self-striping with sort of purples. It's coming out a bit bluish in the light. It is very much just a violet purple with lilac and then grey. And I'm really happy with how these came out. I didn't match them, but I think with the smaller stripe, you can see on the toe actually that I didn't match them. With the thinner stripes, I really don't think it matters. And to be honest, I don't mind not having matching socks. I'm quite happy for them to not match. These are just a vanilla sock. So I'm going to have to shift myself a little bit. I'm sat on the floor, as you may have noticed, because I kept getting too much light in my face if I actually sat up by the window. So these are a vanilla sock. I kind of base my vanilla socks on the Hermione's Everyday pattern by Erica Lueder, which is also a free pattern on Ravelry. But obviously without the textured pattern. it's 15 rows of 2x2 rib, which is actually different to the pattern. I think her pattern calls for a 1x1 rib, but I like a 2x2 rib. And then it's the, just come around this side. The modified Eye of Partridge heel with the garter flap, with the garter stitch edging. It makes it really easy for picking up those stitches. And then it's just I don't even know what the heel flap is called, the heel turn is called actually, but just a slip stitch heel. Not a slip stitch heel, what am I talking about? I'm not making any sense at all. It's a more triangular heel, anyway. There we go. So I'm really happy with these, and that is my next pair of socks. So these are actually my second and my third entry into the Box of Socks KAL for this year. So being March, I'm on track, which I'm really pleased with, because I was a bit worried that I was going to get behind and then I wasn't going to get them finished. So I've said, haven't I, these are a vanilla sock, and the yarn, as I said, is Owl About Yarn. She's got an Etsy shop. I just want to say, actually, everything I talk about, all the yarn and all the patterns and everything, well, maybe not quite all the patterns, but certainly all the yarns and everything I'll talk about, I will link everything down below in the description box in the show notes. So you can always go and check out their shops and things like that. So yeah, this is the Owl About Yarn, and the colourway is Lilac Mist, and it's one of her self-striping colourways. And both of these socks, actually, the yarn, I didn't say, but both of them are a 75-25 merino nylon blend. Took me so long to get my introduction started. I must have recorded it again like seven times that I've nearly finished my tea already. So I shall have to limit myself as I get through the episode. And these will also be entered, as I said, for the Box of Socks KAL and also for the Free All the House Elves KAL as well. But yeah, so that is two pairs of socks finished in the last couple of months. So I'm really, really happy. And I'm looking forward to starting wearing them. Okay, so moving on to works in progress. Let's start with another sock. And these are my Valentine socks. And these are in the these are the Love Along socks by Amy Meeks, which is a paid pattern on Instagram. And I have finished one sock. I have a hoe, as they say. I have a half finished object. So last time I showed these, I had just started the heel flap. I was here. So I finished the heel flap and I have finished the toe of this one. The other one, I've cast it on and I think I've done one row. So I've cast it on, but I've not done much more than that. But they will get done. I just haven't had a lot of time this weekend to do much knitting. So yeah, as I said, this is the Love Along sock. I'll cover my face there because I just can't. There we go. By Amy Meeks, and it's a lovely pattern. It shows much better when it's stretched a bit, so I might just put this on my hand so that I can show you the pattern a little bit better. Can you see? Yeah, you can just about see it there, can't you? It's my first time doing any kind of pattern like this, but I did enjoy it. I struggled to start with. I found it quite difficult to get into, and I found myself not really wanting to pick them up, but when I actually had an evening and I sat down and I really focused on it, I did get there, and then I did kind of enjoy it. I went a bit wrong on the heel. In fact, I learned something on this heel. I've been doing heels wrong. When I slip my stitches on a heel, I've always slipped them knitwise. And I was watching something the other day. I think I was watching a tutorial for... I can't remember. I was watching a tutorial for a stitch that I hadn't done before or couldn't remember how to do. And she sort of said something along the lines of, oh, slip your stitch, but, you know, make sure you slip it pearlized, because if it doesn't specify in the pattern, you should always slip a stitch pearlwise. Now, I've always slipped a stitch knitwise. I don't know why. It's just kind of how I did it. And then when I picked this up, I sort of started doing the stitch pearlwise afterwards, and it's so much nicer. So I don't know if you can see, but below the stitch marker for these lines, I slipped it knitwise, and it's just kind of flat. There's not really much. You can see the slip stitch, but not really. And then above it, I slipped it pearlwise, and it does give you a much, much better texture, and it looks much nicer. So I will be continuing to slip my stitches the right way now that I've learned how to do it. And I'm much happier with it. And to be honest, as I've said before, I don't mind that this is wrong and this is right. I'll look at these socks and this will be a reminder of, oh yeah, that's the project where I learned how to do something. So I'm always quite happy with that. I didn't enjoy this heel as much. I did the heel that the pattern called for, which is it's an Eye of Partridge heel, where you sort of slip the stitches alternately, which gives you the nice pattern. But it doesn't. It's not the modified one with the garter edge. So I found picking up the stitches at the side was a bit trickier, and I don't know. I just didn't enjoy the heel as much. I think I would stick to the modified Eye of Partridge if I was going to be doing an Eye of Partridge heel. But overall, I'm really happy with them. And this yarn is... My cake's a bit of a mess, I'm afraid. Arthur got hold of it. This yarn is getting blown out by the camera. That's the other problem with daylight, I guess, isn't it? This is Peggy May Yarns again. And again, this was another exclusive colourway to her Valentine yarn box. So this is her Valentine colourway. And it's just this gorgeous, it's a really hot pink. It's coming out a little bit more baby pink on the camera. Let's see if I can get a best, slightly better, I don't know. There we go. And it's just got these lovely pops of sort of more hot pink and just take that off. And there's some, yeah, you can see that quite well actually. There's some sort of violety kind of colours in there, purples and hot pinks, but it's mostly just a really tonal hot pink. And it's lovely. I've really enjoyed knitting with this. I really enjoyed the way that you got these little patches and little speckles of different bits in with the tonal pink. I think it's really, really pretty. Yeah, you can see that really nicely there. And again, it's a 75/25 merino nylon. And yeah, I've said the pattern. As I said, this is the... I'll say it again. Why not? Have some tea first. This is the Love Along Socks, is the pattern, by Amy Meeks. And the yarn is Peggy May Yarns. And again, these will be entered into the box of Socks KAL and the Free All the House Elves KAL too. Also, I cast them on as part of the Happy Knitting Podcast's did a Valentine's Day cast on. So I cast these on Valentine's Day. Obviously nearly a month, well, in fact over a month down the line, and I've still only got one sock finished, but I'm fine with that. I just wanted to cast them on with everyone else, and I'm really happy that I did, and I really do love this yarn. I'm looking forward to having these ones finished as well. Okay, so next, just sort some bits and pieces out and have a little shuffle again. The next one is my three-colour cashmere shawl, which I showed as a new cast on last week. And see if I can actually show this off. It's a bit tricky when it's on. It's always a bit tricky when it's on circular needles, isn't it? So this is my three-colour cashmere shawl by Hohe Locatelli. And here it is. And you can see the progress keeper on there is where I was last week. So I've finished this bottom section, this eyelet section, in the two main colours, and I've just started on the thin stripe section, and I am loving knitting on this. I'm really enjoying it. It's really intuitive, and it gives you this lovely edging here, if you can see, this sort of lovely eyelet edging, which took me a little while to get the hang of, but I got there, and yeah, I'm really enjoying it. And the yarns for this one are, I'm using the two greys, which are both stranded dye works, and the dark grey is in her Highway Code colourway, and this is a stranded dye works. This is her Oasis fingering base, which again is a 75/25 merino nylon, and this is her Highway Code colourway, which is this lovely sort of charcoaly dark grey, but very, very tonal. And the light grey is this one here. Let's see if we can get that, there we go. Which is called Spook, and again, it's the same base, her Oasis fingering base in 75/25 merino nylon. And it's just this lovely light grey, and again, they're very tonal, and I don't know if you can pick this up on camera, but you can really see in these, if I can get that nice and close, hang on a second. In these sections here, quite how lovely and tonal the yarn is. I don't think that's coming across quite as well in the light section. It's blowing out a little bit on the camera, but yeah, you can really see how lovely and tonal those yarns are, and I'm really happy with them. And after this striped section, you add in a pop colour. So like a really sort of bright, well, I guess you could add whatever you wanted, but the pattern, the test pattern, was a sort of a bright pop colour, and I've kind of decided to do something similar. So I've got the two greys, and then my third colour is this, which is coming out a little bit bluer on the camera than it is. It's really quite purple. But this is my Sparkle Duck. So this is Sparkle Duck yarn on their Galaxy base, which again is, this is a 75% merino, 20% nylon, and I think you can see there 5% stellina, silver stellina. And it is just this really gorgeous sort of tonal purple. It's a really dark purple. There is some blue in there. There is some, it's coming up quite sort of navy almost, I think, on my screen. But there is some navy in there, but it's mostly sort of purples to sort of magenta-y bits. You can kind of see some of that on the side there. But it is absolutely gorgeous, and I think these will work. I think these will work really nicely together. And yeah, I'm really enjoying knitting this, and I'm looking forward to doing it. Looking forward to doing it. Looking forward to finishing it. So yeah, here it is once more. And as I said, that's where I was. So 2 weeks. And again, it's been a busy 2 weeks, so I've not had a lot of time to knit on this, but I've been really, really enjoying it. Okay, so I'm trying to think if there was anything else I wanted to tell you about this. Oh, I haven't told you about that. Sorry, looking at my notes there. This one, as I said, Sparkle Duck. I'll go through all that again. Yeah. Sparkle Duck yarns. The colourway for this one is called Who Needs Chocolate. Yeah. So that's that one as well. And I haven't got any knit-alongs to enter this into. I'm just knitting this, just enjoying this one for fun. Well, actually saying that, I think Yarn Hoarder is hosting a multicoloured shawl knit-along, but it ends at the end of March, and there's no way that I'm going to have this finished by the end of March, so that's fine by me. I'm not worried. I'm enjoying it. I don't need to knit everything for a knit-along. I can just knit whatever I want, when I want, and enjoy knitting it, can't I? I'm rambling. Okay, let's move on. So that was my shawl. Okay, so now moving on to new cast-ons. I have cast on something new this week, and it is for Jasper. Finally, he's getting something properly knitted for him. I'm not very far into it. Let me just get this. It's living in a organza bag from Wool Warehouse. I made an order with Wool Warehouse, and any of you that know, they send you're knitting in an organza bag. I think it's a handy little project bag when I've not got round to making any of my own yet. Okay, so I am making Jasper. Excuse the ruffling. I'm just trying to find the decent pictures that I wanted to use. I am knitting for Jasper a flax light pullover. I would call it a jumper, being British, but a flax light jumper, which is a Tin Can Knits pattern. It's one of their free ones, part of their simple collection. Again, black and white photographs. I don't know if you can quite see there. I'm loving Tin Can Knits patterns at the moment. I love the way that they go from newborn right up to, I think it's like 4XL men's size or something like that. So it's really, really nice. So I'm knitting this for Jasper. And this is, right, I've not knitted, the reason I've chosen this pattern partly, I've not knit a seamless garment before. I've knitted jumpers and things for Arthur in the past, but they've always been front, back, sleeves, separately, seamed together. So I wanted to try something seamless. I wanted to try knitting a jumper in the round. Mostly, partly because I want to knit one for myself at some point. And I thought trying it out on a baby one would be simpler because it would be quicker and it would be much easier to, if I made mistakes, it would be much easier to sort of fix them and go back. So here it is. I have, it's on small circular, so it's not going to be very easy to show you. But this is, here's the neck. I've finished the increases for the raglan sleeves, if you can just see those there. And this is the, there's a garter panel. I'm sure everybody knows this pattern, but there's a garter panel that runs all the way down the sleeves, from the neck to the sleeves. So that's the garter panel. And then just got the front, and then, as I showed, the raglan increases coming down. And I'm now just on the section where I need to knit straight for a few rows and then separate before I separate for the sleeves. And this is really interesting, having never knit a garment like this before. It's quite interesting because I'm kind of looking at it and I'm thinking to myself, oh, so how's this going to work? And how? And I'm sure when I get to it in the pattern, Tin Can Knits patterns are always written really, really well. They're really, really clear. They always have good tutorials if you need them. And especially the ones from the Simple Collection, because it's designed to teach people to knit, I guess, really. So I'm sure when I get to it in the pattern, it'll all make complete sense when it comes to separating for the sleeves. But yeah, I've been really enjoying it. I am knitting this. There is no wool content in this yarn at all. So I know some people are funny about that, but when I'm knitting a garment for my children, the ones I've knit for Arthur in the past have been knit 100% acrylic. This one is actually a mix of acrylic and nylon. I'll show you the yarn in a second. But I need something that can get shoved in the washing machine. I need something that is going to get covered in food, it's going to get covered in stains, and I'm not going to be worried about having to really work that out and really get them clean. And also, you know, there's always the possibility that if my husband puts the laundry on, he doesn't put it on at 30, or something gets accidentally shoved in the tumble dryer when it shouldn't be. So I just don't want the risk. I want something that's going to be wearable and easy to care for them. So I chose, I've not used this before, but this is knit out of, ooh, that you can't see because that's blowing up beautifully. Oh, anyway, you can't see it, I don't think, because it's blowing out. But this is Siddhar Snuggly 4-ply. And it is, it's going out again, more blue on the screen. It's very much a sort of a green, a foresty green. And the colourway is Little Leprechauns, it was called. And it is a, what is it? It's 55% nylon and 45% acrylic. It's actually very soft. I think the nylon softens up the acrylic. It doesn't feel too plasticky. It is quite soft. And it's actually quite nice to knit with. And it gives quite, I think, anyway, let's see what, but I think it gives quite a nice stitch definition. I do not think that it, I don't think it's too bad. It's quite, it's knitting up really nicely. But it'll be really wearable, and that's what I want. I'm knitting this, it's not going to fit him straight away. I think I'm knitting the age, let's have a look. Yeah, I'm knitting the age 1 to 2. So Jasper will be 1 in November. So I'm kind of aiming for this to fit him in the winter. I thought there's no point in knitting him a knitted jumper for him to wear in the summer anyway, because he just won't wear it. So I'm aiming, yeah, this will be for him for next winter. Hopefully it'll be done by then. I'm sure it will be. I'm actually got plans to make Arthur make Arthur a couple of jumpers, and I'd like to get Jasper a couple more jumpers before the winter as well. So hopefully this will be finished before then. But yeah, I've really been enjoying the pattern, and I'm rambling again, aren't I? Sorry. I've said before, I will ramble. I ramble when I talk normally, let alone when I'm trying to talk to a camera. I've been really enjoying the pattern, and the yarn is absolutely fine. I really do think that acrylic yarn has its place, especially when you're knitting for children. And also for gift knitting and for charity knitting too, because you don't know how people are going to care for it. You don't want to knit them in something that's hand wash only and would felt if it went in the tumble dryer. it's just not worth the risk. All that effort to be put in and have it just ruined is not worth the risk. So yeah, if you're knitting for a child and you want something that is soft and careable, then I would recommend this, actually, Siddhar Snuggly 4-ply. And it says on there, if you can see, no, because it's glaring from the window, there we go. You can wash it in 40 degrees and you can cool tumble dry it, which is exactly what you want when you're knitting for children, really. Okay, so what else did I want to say about this? I think that was it, really. Yeah. So hopefully there'll be a bit more progress on that next week. Hopefully I'll have separated for the sleeves and we'll see how it gets on. Once I've separated for the sleeves, this will be quite good travel knitting, actually, because it's just going to be a full stocking stitch body, which will take a little while, but is nice and easy when I don't have to think about it. Okay, so I was going to show you my blanket this week as well. So we'll move on to some blanket progress. I have actually done quite a bit on this. I've added quite a few squares in. And I have reached the length that I want it as well. Sorry, the width, I guess, that I want it. So it's a bit difficult to show, but here we go. There it is. So it is 12 squares across. And I've showed you these ones I've shown you all before. But I have doubled it. So I've added 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Six, I've added six more squares to it, and I've got one more as well. So I shall show you these. So if I do it like this, I've got this one here, which was one of my Rosie's Moments ones that I picked up, Rosie's Moment minis that I picked up at Unravel. And the Rosie's Moments ones didn't have colourway names. And again, this one here as well, which was also one of the Rosie's Moments ones that I picked up at Unravel. And then I added in this one, which is Easy Knits in their Tropic. Yes, their Tropic colourway, sorry. Again, this was another mini. This was one of the minis that Tom and Arthur bought me at Unravel when they went off on their own for a bit. And then there's this one. This is also an Easy Knits one, and this was in their Zippy colourway. I felt so stupid with this one. I was winding it up, and Tom and I were talking about it, and I was going, oh, isn't this a lovely, lovely rainbow colour? You know, it's really, really nice, all these colours in the rainbow, really, really bright. And he was turned around to me and said, well, that's why it's called Zippy. And I was like, well, what do you mean? Why, what's Zippy got to do with rainbows? And then it twigged. Rainbow, Zippy. So I don't know if anybody else knows it. Obviously, I guess kind of from my childhood, I remember there was the TV show Rainbow, with character Zippy. They were all the sort of puppets. Well, they weren't puppets because they were sort of people dressed up, but in big sort of costume kind of things. And I can't remember if they were, but they were puppets. I don't think they were puppets anyway. But there was Zippy and I can't even remember the names of them all. But anyway, that's where the name comes from the TV show, the kids' TV show, Rainbow. And then there's this one. This one is another mini that they picked me up at Unravel. And this one is Fine Fish Yarns in her Bad Hep colourway. You can see the colours there. Let's show you those ones a bit closer. There you go. Nice rainbow. Bad Hep. And then finally is this one here, and this is the Owl About Yarn that I had for my purple stripy socks. So this is the Owl About Yarn self-striping in the Lilac Mist colourway, and they're all just edged with, again, it's the same, it's the Cascade Heritage grey that I used as the heels and toes for my socks, and I'm going to do the whole blanket edged in this. And then I've also done a square which isn't added in yet, which is this one, which is from my Neville socks. So this is the Alice in Wonderland colourway from my Neville socks. And what I'm planning on doing, so this is now, show it folded in half, I might have a bit of, this is now the length I want it. I want it to be a good sized lap blanket that will go over both mine and Tom's laps when we're sat on the sofa. So this is kind of the length I want it, and I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to create another strip, so I'm going to add more minis to this or more scraps to this to create another strip that's 12 squares long, and then I'll join the two strips together. I think it'll just give a neater join if I join them together that way, rather than adding this one on top and doing it like that. So that's my blanket progress. As I said before, I won't show this every week. I will show this when I think it's had significant progress to make it worthwhile. I'm getting to the point where I've got a lack of scraps and a lack of minis for this. Sorry, I'm just reaching for something now. These are the ones that I've added in. I've still got leftovers of these, and I have got plans for another scrappy blanket. But I have now used all my scraps, and I've used all my minis. Oh, apart from, I've still got one mini. Sorry, there's Mia. Put it all on the floor next to me. I've still got one mini to add in, which is another easy knits one. I haven't wound this up into a ball yet, which is why it's not been added in. I will do that at some point. And I was thinking at some point, sorry, excuse the crinkling if you can hear it. At some point I would like to join in a swap. And what I've actually done is with my scraps from my socks, I have actually created some little, little 10 gram mini skeins. So that's my rainbow sock. So that's the Mothy and the Squid Summer Skies Rainbow. That's from a pair of socks you've not seen, actually, because they were a pair of socks I made last year. So that's Rosie's Moments in her Rainbow Brights colourway. You can see the sparkle in that one. And then I've done one of my, that's my Neville socks. So that's the Alice in Wonderland colourway from Peggy May Yarns. And then there's the purple self-striping colourway from Owl About Yarn. And then this one's a commercial one, but this is the one I knit my first ever pair of socks in, which is Bergère de France in their Goomy 50. And this is the Imprim Rose colourway. So what I was thinking of doing is I was going to put together some minis, some 10 gram minis. And then at some point, hopefully, I'll find somebody that would like to swap with me and I can get some more minis for my blanket. I think each of my blankets, each square, takes me about five to six grams. Sorry, I just had to cut out a bit of a coughing fit there. So as I was saying, each square takes about 5 to 6 grams of yarn, so 10 gram minis would be perfect for that. So at some point I will try and see if I can find somebody that would be interested in swapping. So in fact, if anybody watching is interested in swapping, then please drop me a message. And I haven't got a lot to swap at the moment, but there are definitely these, and as I finish a few more, I will make up more minis of these. And in fact, I might even have some extra of these, because I think some of the leftovers that I've got are still significant. I think there's probably 20 grams left there as well. But yeah, I need to get some more minis to add into my blanket, basically. Excuse me a sec. Okay, sorry about that. Slight break while I have another coughing fit and go and get myself some water to try and calm it down. My voice is getting a bit scratchy. So, I was also planning on sharing with you some yarny goodness. So I've got a few bits that arrived this week. Where shall I start? I made an order with Knit Picks. Anyone that follows me on Instagram will have seen that I tried my hand at dyeing some yarn. I'm not going to show that now. I might show it in a few weeks when I've had a bit more of a go at it and things like that. But it was just for fun and I really enjoyed it. But I made an order on Knit Picks website. Their UK website, just for some of their bare yarn, their undyed yarn. But of course, while I'm on Knit Picks website, I had to get some Knit Picks Felici. And in fact, they had a sale on. I only bought one ball, and this is the one I bought, and it is really getting blown out by the camera. Let's see if it's better on this side. Yes, there we go, that's better. And this is the one I bought. And I only bought one because, so if I show you, there you go, Knit Picks Felici. They're 50 gram balls, and again, it's fingering weight, so it's 75 merino and 25 nylon, again, superwash. And I only bought the one skein because Arthur has been after me to knit him some socks, bless him. He keeps seeing the socks that I've been knitting for me, and he keeps saying to me, "Mummy, you make me socks too." And he really wants a pair of socks. So I thought, you know, just a 50 grams of this, and he can have, he chose the colour. And it is kind of, it's purple, blue, green, in there. And I can't for the life of me remember what the name of the colourway is. I will have to look it up. It's number, oh, it doesn't even give you a number on it. I can't remember what the name is. I think it might be Toucan. I've got that in my head that it might be Toucan. But I'm not 100% sure. I'll put it down here so that you can see what it is. But yeah, and I'm just going to knit him some tube socks, I think. I found a pattern for some tube socks. And I think they'll be perfect because then as his feet grow, it's not going to matter. And I'm not going to have to fit them to him perfectly. But yeah, I will just knit him some tube socks in this. I've not knit with Knit Pigs Felici. And I keep hearing about it. And I've wanted to knit with it for ages. So while I was making the order, I was very tempted to order myself some. But I was good and I behaved myself and I just ordered one ball, one 50 gram ball for him in the sale. But next time it comes around, and because I think the sale was there because they were stopping it for a while, because they do that, don't they, Knit Pigs? Felici is kind of a limited thing. It's on their website for a while, but then they stop it temporarily. I might be wrong, but I think, oh no, hang on, look. Oh, sorry, distracted. I've just distracted myself by finding the colourway name on the packaging. Anyway, yeah, I think that they only do it for a little time and then it goes away and they come back with new colours. So I think the sale was because they are stopping it temporarily, but there may still be some up there. So if you're interested, go and check it out because Knit Pigs had a sale on Felici. And I've just discovered that actually on the label there, let's go this side where the light doesn't shine on it quite so badly, it does say, and there you go, yeah, the colourway is Toucan. I was right. So that came to live with me, and I'm going to just cast him on and knit him some little tube socks in that. And then when I was ordering the yarn for Jasper's jumper, the Siddhar Snuggly, which I didn't say, did I? It's also really, really cheap, which when you're knitting clothes for kids that might get completely ruined, you don't want to knit them something, a 15, 20 pound skein of expensive yarn. I think I needed two balls, and they're 50 gram balls? I think they're 50 gram balls. Two 50 gram balls, so 100 grams of yarn. I think it cost me about a fiver for both balls, so really reasonable. But as I was ordering that, I was looking at the West Yorkshire Spinners yarn. And I've not knit with yet West Yorkshire Spinners before. But I wanted to get a few sort of slightly more commercial sock yarns too. Don't get me wrong, I love the hand-dyed, indie-dyed sock yarn, and that will continue to keep coming and living with me because I'm not very good at not giving in to temptation at the moment. but I wanted to pick up some more commercial sock yarn as well. So I picked up a skein of West Yorkshire Spinners Signature 4-ply. The label is really crumpled, so I'm sorry about that. And I think this is one of their sorry, my brain's just gone dead. Blame it on baby brain. Cocktails. There we go. I got there. So this is one of their cocktail ranges. And excuse me, I've put my glass right there and I can't actually show you things on the screen because it's in the way. Here we go, that's better. In their cocktails range. So this is Sherbet Fizz. And it's a self-striping. It's just these gorgeous pastel colours. It's almost like a pastel rainbow. Which I think is lovely. So I'm looking forward to finishing with this. And as I said, it's their Signature 4-ply. Which is 75% wool, 25% nylon. And as they are, you know, it's a bit toothier, it's a bit rougher than the hand-dyed yarns. It's not merino, but for socks, I think that's fine. I'm looking forward to knitting with this, but yeah, I just couldn't resist this when I was making the order. Something had to get in there for me too. Okay, so I have got one more yarny thing to show you, but I'm going to show you that at the end. I've got a couple of other things that aren't actually yarn, but have also come to live with me. I mentioned a few weeks ago that I was going to make myself some project bags. I haven't got around to making them yet, but I did buy some fabrics. So these are all fat quarters. I'll have a little bit more. Sorry. These are all fat quarters, and I just picked them up at Hobbycraft, which, if you're UK-based, you'll know, it's kind of a big craft store. They do craft stuff for everything. They sell wool, again, mostly acrylic kind of stuff, but they sell sewing equipment, they sell paper craft equipment, they sell baking equipment, they sell artist equipment, they sell everything that you can think of that's craft related. So I picked up some fat quarters, and it's just a mixture of different things. And I think, in fact, I think I've put these into kind of the colours that I'm planning on putting together in the project bags. They're going to be colourful. I do like things colourful and bright. And when you can get away with it, you can get away with it with a project bag, can't you? Because it's not like you've got to wear it or anything like that. It's just something pretty to look at. So I was going with, I keep it on the wrong side. It's gorgeous sort of pineapple fabric with these two to go with it. And then I love this one. So there is this fantastic cactus fabric here. Let me just shift over to the other side. I'm trying to show you. There we go. This fantastic cactus fabric here, which I was going to put these two with. There's this lovely bright sort of birds. I think is that a pelican or a toucan? So it might be a toucan actually. And the parrots there with these bright pink and navy fabric. And then I've got this cute little watermelon fabric, which I was going to put with those two. And you can probably see a bit of a theme. So the patterned fabrics, these ones all came in a pack. There was a pack of the patterned ones, and then there was a pack of stripes and a pack of chevrons. But the colours all kind of went together, so I did get sort of the three packs. And then I've also got, it also had this cute, ooh, that's getting blown out, there we go, flamingo, which I love. And I will probably use some of the fuchsias, because I'll have some of the leftovers of the sort of the contrasting fabrics. I'll probably use some of the fuchsia. And then there's just, again, a few more that I haven't quite worked out how I'm going to use them in with the project bags, but there's these purples, and just I've got a few more bits of those. So at some point I will sit down and do some sewing, and hopefully I will make myself a few project bags, which would be good, because it'll mean I won't have to keep using these and or having things loose, which would be quite handy. So those came to live with me this week. Let's try and stick them back in their little bag. And I also got myself a little progress keeper. I saw this on Instagram and I couldn't resist. This is from, so if I show you the little progress keeper first, see if I can, oh yeah, perfect, look at that. This is a gorgeous little elephant with jewels and trying to get it so that you're not getting too much glare off it. Sort of a white body, and then all the lovely jewels, this gorgeous little progress keeper. And I saw this on Instagram and I couldn't resist, because this reminded me of a brooch that somebody bought for me, some friends of mine bought for me when I was a child. And they'd been to Africa, or India, I can't remember, both places have elephants, don't they? No, I think they'd been to India, actually, thinking of some of the other things that they brought back. I think they'd been to India and they brought me back a little brooch, which was an elephant brooch covered in these little jewels. And I loved it as a child. It was a little pin brooch. But anyway, seeing this on Instagram just brought back memories of this little brooch that I had as a child, and I couldn't resist, and it's so gorgeous. This is from Golden Yarns. I've not bought yarn from her before, but I will do. I follow her on Instagram, and her yarn looks lovely. So at some point, I'm sure some of her yarn will come to live with me. But I just couldn't resist the little progress keeper. And I'll show you, here's her card. I love this card. It's really cute that it's square and the whole knit happens. And then there's her details on the back there as well. But yeah, she's got an Etsy shop, which I ordered it from. And it came really quickly. I ordered it and it pretty much arrived. It arrived so really, really quickly. Maybe not the next day, but certainly the day after. in a lovely little package. So yeah, so that came to live with me. Now, the last thing I wanted to show you comes with a spoiler warning. So this will be, this is the, is it one of Peggy May Yarn's, one of her yarn boxes, and this is the Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone inspired yarn box. Now I received mine on Saturday, I think. So that was the 11th. Yeah, sorry, counting back in my head. I received this, it was the 11th of March. So big spoiler warning, if you haven't received yours, if you've ordered Peggy May Yarns, if you've ordered the Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone inspired yarn box, then don't look. I am going to show you the yarn. If you don't want to see it, then look away now. I'll try not to talk about it too much, so as not to give away the colours and things like that, but I am going to show it. So it came in the post to me. Ooh, flash my address there, hopefully. it came in the post and they come in all wrapped up in tissue paper. And here is the yarn. And the thing I love about ordering these yarn boxes is it takes away, I don't want to say the stress of choosing, because it isn't a stress at all, is it? But I really like the surprise element. I really like that you're getting a skein of yarn and you have got absolutely no idea what is coming to you. I love the surprise aspect. I love that I get something like this, which I would never have chosen these colours, and I love it. I love this, the way these colours go together. I was expecting this colour because I was thinking about sort of the Philosopher's Stone, and I was thinking, well, there's got to be this colour because of the stone in there as well. But it is beautiful, and I'm really looking forward to knitting with this. I'm actually thinking I might have to ball this up, to wind this up. I signed up for the Knitting Expat, the New York Sock Collection, and the first pattern was released at the beginning of this month, and I really want to cast it on. It's driving me mad seeing everybody's patterns and not having cast it on yet, but I can't decide on my yarn. But this might be it, actually. This might have to be the yarn. I think this is variegated enough that, but not too variegated, that it will work with the pattern. I still don't know. I might just need to cake up a few yarns and then make a decision once they're in the cake, I think. But anyway, this is the yarn, the Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone inspired yarn. And it came also with a couple of other little bits and pieces, which again, I won't talk about in much detail in case people don't want to see and don't want it spoiled, but I will just show you. It came with this, which is quite cute. And it also came with this as well. Oh, and I haven't taken it out of the packet. Oh, there you go, you can see it there. Which I think is lovely. So yeah. And I can just show you her card. Sorry, excuse the rustling as I put it back in the tissue paper. Whoops, a daisy. And there you go. So this is Peggy May Yarns. This is her card. And there you go, as it says there. It's literally just, the yarn is called, is Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone inspired yarn. And it is, again, it's a 75-25 merino nylon. So it would make really good socks. And I have also ordered her Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets one, which will be coming in April. So I'm looking forward to that, having seen this one. And I've got some ideas of possibly what colours might come in that one, but I'm not sure. I'll have to wait and see. See whether her inspiration works with my inspiration. Okay, so yeah, I think, let me just check. Yeah, that is all my yarny goodness. So that is basically all the knitting content for my podcast today. I was just going to tell you a little bit now about what we've been up to this week in my behind the scenes section, behind the scenes of behind the scenes of the Giddy Knits podcast. So what have we been up to this week? So it's been 2 weeks since our last podcast. And the first weekend we, on the Saturday, I think it was, we decided to go to, Alice Holt Forest, which is, it's about a 40 minute drive from us, but it's a lovely forest for kids. They've got, a fantastic, play areas and lots of walks that you can go on that have got interest for children along the way. So Alice really enjoys it. Arthur really enjoys it there. However, we had a bit of a parenting fail. So in the morning, we made a picnic. Arthur thoroughly enjoyed helping make the picnic. He spent time doing it. He helped make the sandwiches. We got it all ready with him. We got about 10 minutes away from Alice Holt. So 30 minutes down the road. And we suddenly realised we'd forgotten the picnic. In all the chaos of getting two children out the house, we'd forgotten the picnic. Arthur was distraught. He was so upset, bless him. He really, really was. And yeah, it took a while to calm him down. And in fact, the only thing that calmed him down was the promise that when we got home, we would have our picnic for dinner. Which is what we had to do. So we had a lovely day at Alice Holt Forest. He really enjoyed it because he'd calmed down by the time we got there. We bought lunch at the cafe. Fortunately, there's a cafe there. But yeah, he had a lovely time playing and we really enjoyed it. I'm sure I'll put a few pictures at the end. But then when we got home, we had to have picnic. We had to get the picnic blanket out and put it on the floor, sort of right here. and have our sandwiches for dinner. Which was the only thing that calmed him down, and he was so excited about that. We got through the door, we got home at about 4:30, and he ran straight to the fridge to get the picnic out. And we had to say, Arthur, it's not dinner time yet, you need to wait a little bit for dinner time. But yeah, so though that was quite fun, he did really enjoy it, and we had a really nice day out. And then this weekend's been really busy, actually. Tom has been away. He's been in Poland. That's not quite how you say it, is it really? He's been in Poland for not quite a conference, but work related. He's been in Poland for work. I don't know if I've said what he does. Tom is he's a university lecturer. He lectures in law, and he researches as well in law. And I'm going to get this completely wrong, but anyway, legal philosophy, I think. And it all goes over my head because I've never studied law. I come from a psychology background rather than a law background, but anyway. So he's been in Poland this weekend, and actually my mum came to visit to help me out with the kids, and it coincided with the fact that my aunt and uncle were also coming over. They live in France, but they come over regularly for work, and when they do, they tend to stay with us for a couple of nights. So they suddenly messaged and said, oh, we're going to be over, can we stay with you? And I was sort of like, well, you can. Tom's not here, and Mum's staying too. but that's fine. Sorry, another coughing-related temporary break there. So I said to them, yeah, no, that's fine. So they joined us as well. I had a full house. We live in a two-bedroom flat. So Mum actually had to share a bed with me, bless her, and my aunt and uncle slept in here. We've got, you can't quite see it, it's just next to me over here, but we've got a sofa bed in the lounge for when we have visitors. So yeah, it was quite a full house actually, but it was great because I had loads of help with Arthur and Jasper, and we had a really lovely time. Mum, bless her, I think was a bit disrupted by sharing a room with me. I mean, actually, the sleeping aspect was fine, but obviously, as I said, I've got Jasper is 4.5 months old, So he's still in our room with us at night, and he obviously he still wakes up in the night for feeds. I'm feeding him, so yeah, he wakes up in the night for feeds, and usually he's very good. And he was very good, but he definitely, I think Mum found it a little bit disturbing getting woken up when I woke up to feed him. I tried to be as quiet as possible, but even so, you know, if you're not used to it, it can be disturbing. But she coped admirably. Probably reminded her of what it was like when me and my brother were little babies. So on Monday, actually, we all went out for the day, and we went into London. Surrey, where I'm from, if you're not from the UK, is just on the outskirts of London. And in fact, I live inside the M25. I live inside the M25. So it's actually not too bad a journey into London. We were able to just jump on the train to get into central London. We went to the Natural History Museum. We haven't taken Arthur to the Natural History Museum yet. And if anybody knows it, it's one of the big museums in London, one of the free ones, and they've got fantastic displays about animals and the world and human biology. But the thing they are probably most known for is their dinosaur exhibition. They've got a fantastic dinosaur exhibition, and it has got a massive, massive animatronic T-Rex. Absolutely enormous and really, really impressive, actually. I'd not quite remembered how good the animatronics were in this T-Rex. It was so lifelike. It really, really was. So we went to that, and actually Arthur loved it. He really enjoyed it. He was terrified of the T-Rex. It took some convincing. I had to carry him in. I had to kind of really talk to him. I was saying to him, it's a robot, it's not real, it's okay, it's just a robot, it's, you know, it's not going to do anything, it can't move, its feet are stuck to the floor, and all this kind of thing. And eventually we got from the back of the room right up to the rail, and he did really enjoy it once he got over his initial terror. So that was a really nice day out. And we walked a little bit along the South Bank. So we walked over Westminster Bridge, past the building's Parliament, past Big Ben. It was quite nice, actually, to get the chance to go and see Big Ben again, because it's apparently getting covered up, I think, this summer. And it's going to be covered up for about 5 years, I think, while they're renovating it. So actually, a lot of people aren't going to get the chance to see it when they come into London. And we were right by the London Eye as well. So it was just nice to see a little bit of London. We don't go in as often as we'd like to. We used to. We used to go in quite a lot. But obviously with children, managing everything is a little bit more challenging. And we just don't have the time to do it as much nowadays. So it was really nice to get into central London. So that's what we've been up to in the last couple of weeks. There's not really much more. This weekend felt busy because I had so many visitors and I didn't get a lot of knitting time, because in the evenings we were kind of chatting and playing games and things like that rather than being able to knit. But I really enjoyed it. So enough of the ums. I need to work on that, but oh well. It's me. I am in real life, and if you don't like it, I'm sorry. But hopefully you will be fine with it. So that's all my knitting, and that's what we've been up to in the last couple of weeks. I will leave it there. If you've enjoyed watching, then please give me a thumbs up, like the video down below, and hit subscribe. I'd really like to get to the stage where I have enough subscribers that it would be worthwhile starting a Ravelry group, because I think that would be really fun to be able to communicate with people in that kind of forum. And maybe even do some knit-alongs and things like that. If you've enjoyed it, then please subscribe and like the video, and hopefully more people will find us. So I will leave you there. Thank you very much for watching. I'll leave you with some photographs of what we've been up to, as I usually do at the end, and I look forward to talking to you in a couple of weeks' time. I hope you have a really good couple of weeks. And I will talk to you then. Okay, bye.